Hi there, it's Nakia, and today I'll be doing a super simple skincare routine. This is for oily or combination skin. I'm going to focus on hydration today, so a lot of the products you will see me use really aid in hydration, and I absolutely love them. So first, before I start, I wash my hands. It's absolutely important for you to wash your hands when you're dealing with your face. And my first step would be to do a pre-cleanse using DHC's Deep Cleansing Oil. You should be using this oil on a dry face. Anytime you pre-cleanse, it should be done on dry face, actually. There's a whole science as to why it works. I will not bore you with the details today, but just know that you need to break down any product that you put on your skin. So sunscreen, makeup, mascara, eyeshadow. You really want to break down the products that are on your face. It's kind of like using a makeup wipe, but this is better than using makeup wipes. So I like to massage this into my skin for about 30 to 60 seconds. So after I'm done massaging this into my skin, I want to wash this off with lukewarm water. Not too hot, not too cold. You need it just right. Otherwise, we burn our skin off, we're stripping it of multiple oils, all of those things. I then follow up with a cleanser, which is the CeraVe's Renewing SA Cleanser. I absolutely love this cleanser. It does everything it claims, starting with being a gentle exfoliant. It's so gentle that I could use it 2 times a day, and my skin does not feel like it has been stripped of all the oils and is completely dry. So again, I like to massage this into my skin for 60 seconds. The 60 seconds is super important because we need the cleanser to actually work. The cleanser is the only product that we're going to use that does not stay on the skin. Therefore, we need it to actually do its job, which is to cleanse. And the average person apparently only cleanses their face for 15 seconds, which is not long enough to break down any of the product, any of the dirt. So after rinsing off my cleanser, I like to gently get some of the water off of my skin, not too much of it, using this Clean Skin Club towel. These are really good. They help keep bacteria off of your skin. They're single use. There's 2 sides to it, a textured side and a smooth side. I just love them. Next, I'm going to tone using Dr. Jart's Ceramidin Moisturizing Toner. This has a bit of a watery texture and it's very moisturizing. I like to pat it into my face first. You'll see me doing upward strokes near my eyebrows. That's just because I have a weird thing about any lines. So I will always do that in that area. But overall, you should be patting this into your face, really making sure that you get that under eye area. This is a product that is safe to go in the under eye area. Don't get it in your eye, but you want to put it under that under eye area because that area just doesn't produce a lot of oil or moisture. This next step in my routine is typically where I like to treat any issues that I have, any areas of concern. So here today I'm using Paula's Choice Salicylic Acid. This is really good, helping with inflammation. It helps to reduce inflammation. It also helps to prevent bacteria or bad bacteria from getting into your pores, which can cause acne. It's really good, so gentle on the skin. I can use it every day. I don't choose to just because I have other actives in my skincare routine, but it's really good. So this next product that I'm gonna use is polyglutamic acid. It, in my opinion, does not get enough recognition. It is far better than hyaluronic acid, if you ask me. It's so good at pulling in all the hydration, and it's just a great layering product. Again, we gotta make sure we really get the product into our skin. I like to bring it up near my eye area because why not? We need all the moisture we can get. The next product is my absolute favorite and a game changer in the moisturization department, if you ask me. It is Kiehl's Ultra Facial Moisturizer. This is an OG. I have used it in all forms. They have a cream, they have SPF. It's really good. And my skin is always left feeling very nourished
and supple and soft.
So last but not least, you always need a little sunscreen, especially if this is the daytime. I'm using Black Girl Sunscreen SPF 30. I love it. You should also be using 50 or higher if you have active ingredients anywhere in your skincare routine. And you just want to make sure you're putting on enough sunscreen. It should be 2 finger lengths, and then you rub it in your skin. I really like this because it doesn't leave a white cast. And again, my skin is just left feeling very glowy, soft, and supple. Now that we've come to the end of my super simple skincare routine, let me know in the comments if there's something that was helpful that you learned in this video. Also, like, subscribe, and share with a friend.